I have always been fascinated by fashion since I was young. So I started actually studying fashion in Geneva, in Switzerland, 16 years ago. So it's really amazing to come back to Switzerland for a solo exhibition somehow 16 years later. So, well, anyway, I finished studying fashion in Canada, in Montreal. Then I worked in the fashion industry. I did my master classes in media arts. That's why I started working as a fashion designer using media and new technology. At the same time, I started teaching at the university as a fashion design professor. I have been working with new technologies, sometimes as tools, sometimes as a source of inspiration. It depends. So sometimes my garments have the technology inside. Sometimes it's way behind in the process, in the creative process. This project, which is called Indice de l'indifférence, basically was because I was inspired by the online survey, actually by the number of the people who say, I'm indifferent, I don't care about social, economical, political questions daily. So I made 10 shirts based on those numbers, those digital data to show how indifference makes difference in our society. This project is called Uniforms. Very funny story, because I teach at the university, and one day I just read a statement on a blackboard, which is written, speed kills creativity. I was just thinking that it doesn't make any sense. So I decided to make do a project with within 5 seconds. Basically, I picked up 2 uniforms, and then I just morphed it with software. And then we had 7 uniforms within 5 seconds. So speed, basically, I think, doesn't have anything to do with the creativity. This project is called Working City. Basically, it's a tribute to Archigram for their conceptual utopic work. Basically, these dresses are interactive using microprocessors, pneumatic system, and origami techniques. So they just move with air. Living Pod is another interactive project. I made 2 interactive codes using micro motors, micro processors, and light sensors. So basically, one the user uses flashlights or a camera with a flash, the codes moves. So after air, I just wanted to use another element, a tangible, intangible element, such as light. This project is called Swiss Quality One because it's sponsored by five different textile enterprises in Switzerland, and those are amazing fabrics. I wanted to make five similar garments, but very different because of their material. This is a part one, actually. The part two is coming, and it's a secret because it's going to be a technological interactive project using Swiss mineral water and Swiss textile again. It's coming.